What is the clipboard? Where is the clipboard? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question. You've mentioned copying to the clipboard. What and or where is this mysterious clipboard? Many times as I've closed a program, the screen will pop up and tell me I have a lot of information on the clipboard and do I want to save it? I haven't a clue where to look to find out what or where it is. Is there a clipboard that has everything I've copied somewhere? So, the clipboard is another one of those small but incredibly powerful little items that we often take for granted. It's such a simple thing, and yet we never talk about what it is or why one would care. We just use it constantly, every day. The clipboard isn't so much a thing as it is a place, but place isn't really accurate either. The clipboard is where Windows remembers something. By default, exactly one thing for you. That's it. That's all. But as simple as that is, it's extremely powerful. You place things into the clipboard using copy or cut commands in various applications and Windows itself. For example, I have here in Notepad a little bit of text. If I select some of that, like I'll select the where is the clipboard text here, I can type Control C, or I can right click on it and click on copy. It's been copied to the clipboard. There's no place to look. There's nothing you can see, but it has. Cut, by the way, does the exact same thing by cut, but it's followed by a delete. So copy makes a copy of whatever you've selected and places it in the clipboard. Cut does the exact same thing and then follows it with a delete. So it's the equivalent of a copy followed by a delete. Okay, great. We've got this in the clipboard. Now what? The opposite of copying something into the clipboard is to copy something out. That's called the paste operation. Paste copies whatever is in the clipboard and places it at the current location or selection location. For example, let's go back here to Notepad. I'm going to throw in a few blank lines, and now, using either Control V to paste or right-click, click on paste, poof. That's what is in the clipboard right now. To be honest, when I'm curious about what did I last have in the clipboard, I'll often fire up Notepad, a blank document, and just hit Control V to see what shows up. That tells me what's in the clipboard. Now, what's interesting is that, of course, I said we haven't changed the contents of the clipboard. All we did was copy whatever is in it into this document, which means we could paste multiple times. For example, I will hit Control V again and again and again and again and again. All we're doing is we're copying things from the clipboard to wherever the cursor happens to be in this document. So, copy or cut puts things in the clipboard. Paste copies the contents of whatever is in the clipboard to your selected destination. Now, you can use the clipboard for many, many different things. The basic, most simple operation is what I've just shown you here. We've selected some text, we've copied or cut it, and we've pasted it. And then you can just do whatever you want with that. You can copy and paste images if the application you're copying from supports it, and the application you're pasting into supports it. For example, I can't paste a picture into Notepad because Notepad doesn't support pictures. On the other hand, if I were using a word processing program, then yeah, I could probably paste a picture into the document that I'm working on. Windows File Explorer even uses the same metaphor, the cut, copy, paste metaphor, to allow you to move or copy files. But honestly, the real power of the clipboard isn't in this simple file or text manipulation. The real power of the clipboard is that it's in Windows, and it's provided to all the applications choosing to use it. You can copy text from one application and paste it into another. A great example of that might be to fire up a web browser, go to your favorite website, select some text on that website, use copy, and now go over to your, well, wherever you want. I'm going to select everything here so that we're going to replace it with a paste. Poof, I've just copied text from my web browser into Notepad. You can copy files in Windows Explorer and paste them into email where they become an attachment. You can copy a photo from a website and paste it into a graphics program to save it or modify it. You can copy a file from one disk drive and paste it to another to make a backup copy. You get the idea. There's a lot you can do with the clipboard. But where is the clipboard? It's in Windows. That's as close as we can really get to answering that question. Where it lives and how Windows keeps track of it is completely hidden within Windows itself. And honestly, we don't need to know, as long as it works. Now, most folks wondering where the clipboard is are looking to see what it currently holds. I've already outlined one approach that I use. I just paste whatever's there into an empty document. But there's a better way. There's another way. We can use clipboard history. So I'm going to go ahead and close my windows here. In the settings app, search for clipboard, clipboard settings, and turn on clipboard history. Now, I've had it on this entire time. You'll notice that it has not interfered in any way with our normal usage of the clipboard. However, what this means then is that if we want to paste, well, you could do something different. I'm going to fire up Notepad again, which has an empty document. Clicking in it, this time instead of right-clicking or instead of using Control V, I'm going to use Windows key V. And you can see here, off to the side, I'll make the settings app go away. If I hit Windows V again, you can see that's what's in the clipboard right now. This top item is in the clipboard. The item below it, that was what's in the clipboard before. We normally talk about the clipboard holding one and only one thing. And without clipboard history turned on, that is true. If you copy something to the clipboard, it overwrites what is currently in the clipboard. But with clipboard history, what's currently in the clipboard, well, gets saved. It gets pushed down the list. And whatever you just copied gets placed at the top of the list. If we just hit Control V, we're always pasting whatever is at the top of the clipboard history. However, if you're looking at the clipboard history as we are right now, you can choose to paste either of these things. If I click on this, it has pasted that text. If, on the other hand, I bring up clipboard history again, and I click on the other one, poof, it pastes that. So, clipboard history, Windows key V. You can hit escape to make it go away, or you can click on one of the items and it will be pasted into your current position. Honestly, I'm positive that's why they use Windows key V, which of course is similar to a normal paste, Control V. The clipboard kind of sort of really only holds one thing, which means that if you're using Control C, Control V, etc., as you have in the past, you're only going to be doing that top most recent item from the clipboard. But with clipboard history, you can A, see what's in the clipboard, and B, maybe choose something that used to be in the clipboard or that you copied earlier. I honestly recommend strongly that you learn about and use the clipboard. Computers are really, really good at copying things, and that's what the clipboard is all about. You'll likely find it will become one of your most used actions. Honestly, my backspace key is probably my most used key, just because of the kind of typist I am. But high on the list, Control C and Control V for copy paste. They both beat the heck out of retyping long, complicated text. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/5030. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.